at Riverview Middle School. Thank you so much for being here. This is our first, our ensemble, the 6th grade choir, our first performances of the evening. So let's give them a giant round of applause, please. I'm going to try to go quickly this evening. I'm not going to talk as much as I normally would, but our first piece this evening is entitled When I Close My Eyes. It actually comes from the Wisconsin School of Music Association's list of songs that kids can sing at solo and ensemble. So if you were looking at the program, there are many students that are in 7th and 8th grade students. They're not on this program, but 7th and 8th grade students go and sing at an event at a different school. Next year it's actually in Plymouth. But they sing and are critiqued by a clinician. And this song will now set them ready. They'll be ready to go if any of them choose to do that next year. That's why I chose it. The other thing we talk about within this piece is it's about, the composer wrote it based on an experience he had in another country. And it's about kids having moments of sadness and finding dreaming and thinking in a different way. So within the piece, we hope you can hear the beginning of the sadness. Then the child goes into a dreamland, and then they come back into reality. So we hope we can hear those couple of things within the piece. We hope you enjoy. I'm so sorry. Let's give Mrs. Zimmerman a round of applause. I promise that was my fault. I miscommunicated with her. She's not playing for all of our songs tonight, so she thought she was waiting for three. Instead, she's playing for three. So clearly I messed up. So thanks to all for being patient.
Thank you.
choir student to Rocky Knoll. And these students got to take that experience. So all of December, we learned Christmas carols, and we practiced and all that stuff in their lessons and in class after our concert. And then we did go to Rocky Knoll, and we sang for the elderly. It was a really beautiful experience. There were some parents who attended, and I think they would all say that it was a really great time for our students, as well as the people that lived there. Then throughout the month of January, we worked on learning how to read music. So reading music is a new language to these children, as well as most of you. So we work on those skills of how do we do that? What does that mean? What are these notes? And how high do I sing and why? We're not great at it yet, but we're still working on it. So we spent a lot of time learning how to read and then how to write. And then, that was pretty much, and then we get to February and we start working on concert materials. So throughout this concert, we worked a lot on the terms harmony and melody. And harmony and melody are, does anybody want to define melody? Gabby? The main part. So in that last song, when I close my eyes, then I can see, when I close my eyes, I'm alive. That's the melody. So what is harmony? Lucy? The part that makes it interesting. So if you were listening, you would hear, when I close my eyes, then I can see, when I close my eyes, I'm alive. That's a melody, or that's a harmony, excuse me. So throughout each of our pieces this trimester, we worked really hard on identifying when am I singing melody and when am I singing harmony. So this piece is actually going to feature both groups being able to sing both of them. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
our hardest piece that these sixth graders are singing tonight. I actually say that it's one of the hardest on this entire concert this evening. I'm really proud of them. You'll notice that the melody comes between both groups. So some, just a teaching moment. So when I teach this, raise your hand if you are an orange. Raise your hand if you're an other color. So in class, we have our groups set up into two, and if you notice, sometimes I'm pointing to the melody over here or the harmony over here. I switch those for every song so that every kid learns how to sing melody and harmony. So by the time they get to high school or even a seventh grader, they're not used to just singing the melody every time and it's easy for them. So it's just a teaching strategy I use to make sure that they get those concepts in here. So Here Comes the Sun, it's hard, but it's really cool. And we worked on our reading skills as well as that harmony and just understanding. So we did a little research on this song, and the Beatles actually didn't get to sing this really together live ever, because by this point, they weren't together. When it was written, they sang it once for their recordings, and I think there's like two recordings of it live, but that's it. So we did a little research on that, which is kind of fun, because many kids don't know some of these artists that are really big, that they should know. So it was really cool to give them that experience as well. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
classroom musical newsies, and I do like to see have parents see what our classroom looks like every day, so I'm going to play piano. I don't have Mrs. Zimmerman every day. She comes in one time before our concert. That's all we get to work with her. So I like to show you kind of more what our students really see every day. The performance aspect is awesome, but it's also a teaching classroom. So we hope you enjoy our next lecture.
Down.
traditional Hawaiian piece. So the students had to learn how to sing in Hawaiian. They have to sing without a piano and just listening to tonal center. So it has been a challenge for them. So we spent a lot of time singing in circles in my classroom of just practicing listening to each other. This one, I think, is the most challenging that they sang, but I hope you enjoy.
I hope you enjoy it, but hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Parker Hamer. God, it's so fun to watch him. So Parker, can you raise your hand? I know sometimes I block him. He's really fun to watch if you're like looking for a kid that's really enjoying music. But isn't it fun now, like, to know, like, oh, they're working on that. So you can see some kids are really good into their practicing and their facial expressions. So our next piece is The Lion Sleeps Tonight, which when we talked about facial expressions today, we said, like, bring in your inner Timon and Pumbaa, which many of these kids experienced because they were in The Lion King last year. So this song will feature Alexa Ritchie, Phoebe Mills-Lagle, Caden Cincinnati, and Sophia Shaw. And when we practiced, we did lots more circles and a cappella singing with it. We hope you enjoy. Silliness, but we get a lot done and we have a lot of fun doing that. So thank you so much for continuing to foster that love in this community and in these schools. Thank you so much. So, safe travels. Tonight, this song is not getting an introduction. You will know it. Most of you should know it, or would maybe know it, when I start playing. Again, I'm going to give you a view of what our classroom looks like. I'm going to jam out on the piano, and they're going to jam out with their voices with you. Thank you so much for being here this evening.